Behind Bonjour is Linsman. Aaron races to the puck. He gets a bump from Linsman, something you certainly would expect. Keith Crowder, who will be playing against his brother Bruce tonight, who was picked up by the Penguins. And now we have a fight in the opening minute of play. It is Buskis going up against Crowder right in front of the Pittsburgh net.
Well, we assumed that O'Reilly, Linsman, and Keith Crowder were going to not only supply some excitement for us tonight, but they are a tenacious line. Intensity, everything all over them, but Keith Crowder leaving the ice surface right now.
25 seconds into the game, there's a fight. Off the boards, intended for Babbage, and Babbage belts Curran into the boards. Wayne Babbage, certainly a very interesting story. 54-goal scorer 4 years ago with the St. Louis Blues, but has tailed off incredibly, scoring 19 goals, 16, and then 13 his last 3 seasons. And here he is, moving in on the big 6'6", Curran.
Well, there you see Curran going down. Babbage is strong.
Cleared out to the blue line. Bork, the crowd excited, and there is Mario Lemieux, and he is off, racing in all alone. Lemieux, his first shot on goal, and he scores! Mario Lemieux, living up quickly to all the advertisements on his first shot on goal. Walks in on Pete Peters, puts on a deke, leaves Peters out to dry, and Mario Lemieux is now the leading scorer in the NHL.
Allie didn't even give me a chance to say that the first goal is the toughest one. Watch Lemieux coming in over that blue line. Just big strides this man has got. He goes with the deke, beats Peters cleanly. A lot of pressure off of this young man right now. Scoring that first one. Going to his backhand with that deke. I imagine he feels real good about that one.
Well, he certainly looks at Montreal on Saturday, and then Wednesday, October 17th, their home debut against Vancouver. Now, the far side, it is Marty McSorley, who certainly will rough things up.
And Nevin Marquardt, he will not back down from anything. They call him the Kamikaze Kid. I love that nickname, and he plays exactly like that.
And now it is blown down by Fraser. We have action again. It is Boutet against the big John Bloom. Stands at 6'3". Boutet has really been scrappy. Now Lemieux is in the middle of it, and you know the Boston Bruins are seeking him out. Lemieux, who could certainly handle himself at 6'4", 200. Doesn't look for the scraps, but he's there if contended with.
John Blum was the player that really started doing some of the pushing and shoving.
Fires his check there by Bonjour in front. Score! The Bruins strike quickly. A bang-bang play. And the Bruins get their first of the season.
Well, Tom Fergus was not too pleased after scoring that goal. He got pushed around a little bit. Nevin Marquardt, number 17, jumped right into his defense.
Have it lined up. O'Connell, what a bullet! And Heron knocked down by his own man, Hannon, but Hannon was pushed into his goaltender. Fergus in front again. Fires the shot. Heron all over the ice. And it comes out with 27 seconds to go. And some extracurricular activity. Marquardt and Maxwell. It is broken up. Fraser very quick on the play. And we'll see if he whistles him down. I believe he will. Stops him. Bork walks in. Saved by Heron, who is downed by that bullet shot. It hit him in the shoulder. Bork about 20, 25 feet away.
Al, you described it well. It was a bullet, just like a shot out of a gun. Raymond Bork blasted that puck. Worked for, but this is the one right here that Raymond Bork had labeled for that top corner.
Bork had gotten it up. A wrist shot by Bork, and it hits around the shoulder area, which is a vulnerable area for a goaltender. He has padding there, but it's not real thick. Now with 6 minutes gone by in the third, the stick goes flying of Babbage. Keogh pushed away by Bork. Lemieux out to Bodger. He has time. And it's blocked by Middleton. Another example of his all-around play. Lindsman almost had a breakaway as he bounces into Bullard.
Well, Mike Bullard wants a piece of Ken Lindsman. Lindsman's just very coolly trying to aggravate Bullard the best he can. He's skating away and having a few words over the linesman's shoulder. There we'll see it one more time. It was a sandwich play, in fact. Number 27, Matt Taillon and Ken Lindsman. It's going to help them this year if they continue it.
Silk looking for four. Fires, scores! Crowder and the save by Peters. And there goes the net once again as the fight breaks out. Young for the Penguins, mixing it up. I believe that's Byers for the Bruins. Lyndon Byers, the rookie, who is getting the right in there. The uppercut and going with the hook. Underneath and around, they say in boxing. And that is what Young is doing there, or at least getting from Byers.
Well, I don't think you'll hear as loud as cheers for fisticuffs any place in the league as you'll hear here at the Boston Garden.
So Byers doing some strong scoring, although Young able to score with his hook. And a hand for the rookie, Lyndon Byers. Just 20 years old, a second-round draft pick in 1982. He's a former junior teammate of Nevin Marquardt. And there is Warren Young. Two goals scored tonight for the Pittsburgh Penguins. His evening is over. And it is all over. The Bruins come from behind and win the home opener against the Pittsburgh Penguins by the score of 4-3.